Hello, you're welcome to this lesson. In this video, you are going to solve this question I have on the screen. The question says, find the moment about point O. Okay, so I've already solved this question using two other approaches. Okay, and then in this video, I'm going to use another approach, which is the third approach, okay, to solve this question. So for this approach, I'm going to use the principle of transmissibility, which states that the point of application of a force can be moved anywhere along its line of action without changing the external reaction forces on a rigid body. So if you look at the actual figure that was given to us, the 600 Newton was applied at point A. Okay, but from the free body diagram that I have here, we have been able to transmit the force, okay, from point A to point B and then C. Okay, so I'm going to use this to find the moment. Okay, you can actually choose to do for only point B or do for only point C. Okay, they will all give you the same answer, but in this case I'm going to solve for both points so that you see how they work. Okay, so for the force, you're going to have the F1, which is the S component, to be 600 cosine of 40 degrees, and then you're going to have F2, which is the Y component, to be 600 sine of 40 degrees. Okay, let's take note of this. Okay, so now when you look at point B, okay, we are considering point B first. When you look at point B, you see that F2 is acting directly on point O, right? So that means that doesn't have any perpendicular distance from the line of action of the force, so that perpendicular distance will be zero. For that reason, the moment that F2 will cause about point O from point B will be what, zero. So our moment now will be the moment that will be caused by what, F1, and then that will be the moment about point O, standard point B, that will be F1, okay, multiplying D1. Okay, so now our main goal here will be to find D1. So let's look at how you are going to find D1. Okay, so from the figure that we have, okay, we know that we have an angle of 40 degrees, okay, at this point here, right? You have an angle of 40 degrees here, so for that reason, you are going to have here also to be 40 degrees, okay. So let me name here as X. Okay, let's name here as what, that side as what, X. And then from the figure that was given, you know that we have from this point here to this point here to be 4 meters, right? So that would tell us that D1 will be equal to 4 meters, okay, plus what, X. So our goal here will be to find X. So looking at this triangle that we have here, okay, we are going to have the tan of the angle 40 degrees to be equal to the opposite side, which is the X, okay, over the adjacent side, which will be 2 meters. Okay, this distance here from the figure, you can see it, so that'll be X over 2. So you're going to have the X to be equal to 2 tan 40 degrees. Okay, so in all, you're going to have D1 to be equal to 4 plus 2 tan, okay, 40 degrees. Okay, so from here we are going to have the moment about point O to be equal to F1, okay, which will be 600 cosine of 40 degrees, okay, multiplying D1, which will be 4 plus 2 tan of 40 degrees. Okay, so let's see what you are going to get. Okay, so let's look at what you are going to get. So we have 600 cosine of 40 degrees, that gives us a value of 459.627. This will be multiplying 4 plus 2 tan of 40 degrees, which will give us a value of 5.678. So let's multiply these two and see what you are going to get. 459.627 multiplying 5.78. That's 5.678. Okay, that gives us a value of 2609.762. Okay, I can round this value to 2610, newton meter. Okay, and this is the value that I got from the previous example. So I just try to run it so that it will match those values. Okay, you might not get the same value depending on how you run your decimal figures. So this will be the moment about 0.0. Okay, so now let's try and solve it using point C also. Okay, so for point C, you know that F1 is acting directly on point O here, so it will not have any moment, okay, effect on the point O. So the only moment will be caused by F2. So I'm going to have the moment about point O, starting from standing at point C to be equal to F2 multiplying D2. So our goal here now will be to find D2. So let's look at how you are going to find D2. Okay. So to find D2, I'll draw a perpendicular line here, okay, from point A, okay, to pass through the line of action of the force F1, okay, or I'll draw a line from point A to pass through D2, okay, and then you know that we have an angle of 40 degrees here, okay, we have an angle of 40 degrees here. Okay, so for this reason, we are going to have 40 degrees here also. And then you know this distance here will be 4 meters, right? And then this distance here will be 2 meters, okay? So you're going to have D2, okay, to be equal to 2 meters, okay, plus, let's name here as X again, okay? So that'll be 2 meters plus what? X. So our main goal here will be to find X. Okay, so how do you find X? So looking at where X is, okay, if I take tan of 40 degrees, okay, that will be equal to the opposite side, which will be 4 meters over the adjacent side, which will be what? X. So I'm going to have X to be equal to 4 over tan 40 degrees, okay? So I'm going to have D2 to be equal to 2 plus 4 over tan 40 degrees. So you're going to have the moment, okay, to be equal to 600 sine of 40 degrees, okay, multiplying 2 plus 4 over tan of 40 degrees, okay. Let me clean what you have here. All right, so let's look at what you are going to get. Okay, so we have 600 sine of 40 degrees, okay, multiplying 2 plus 4 over tan 40. So let's see what you're going to get for that value. So you are going to get 2609, okay, 0.85, okay, newton meter. Then I'm going to run this value to 2610, okay, 0.0 newton meter, okay, just like I did for the point B, so that you get value that will match the previous example that I got. You see, for the previous examples, I didn't write them into two decimal places, okay? So that's why I try to run them up to get this value. Thank you very much for watching this video.